Hey, what's up, guys? GC Dunkaroo. We are back with Rookie in the opening round of the Ventura Open. In the qualifying, we just kind of blazed through it, shot a minus 12, and I don't know how much better we can do, but minus 12 is going to be a really good score. If we could get that again, we, you know, minus 24, we would definitely get into the weekend round. So I didn't really make a lot of changes or anything like that than we did in the opening round or the qualifying round. I felt like it was a really good score. So we're just going to go through and blaze through this, and we will kind of see how things go from there. So, all right, guys. Hole number one. That's a hole one. We're going to use the quarterback and Thorn. Try to see if we can find this little funnel and knock it into the hole. In the qualifier, we were much too aggressive and actually hit the stick on a roll, and the ball bounced out and we took our birdie. So without having a ball guide, we're at a little bit of a disadvantage, but I think we can overcome that you know, by just making a small adjustment, adding one bar of backspin, and kind of taking it from there. All right, so 10% on the drive, and 5.1 is the wind, so it's going to be about 5 rings. So this is max right here, so we're just basically going to go full top and then go 5 rings and push up. Slide over just a little bit, and then we're gonna go full top and put some curl on it. And hopefully that'll stop right in min thorn range. Might be a little long, but we'll just have to see what it gives us. All right, so this shot is almost like a no-spin shot. So 3-7 at min is going to be one ring. Let's see how that turns out. Oh man, just missed. Had the right idea. Like I said, without a ball guide, it's really hard to tell exactly where the funnel is. But we were pretty close there. All right, so for hole two, we're gonna switch to a Marlin ball and a backbone. And so when we played it at 15%, we ended up going right of the hole. So I'm going to play it at 20%. And I'm going to take about a bar of backspin off of it. Because we came up about a yard or two short of the hole as well. Alright, so 5 is the wind at 20% is going to be 4.1 rings. So I'm going to take, like I said, just a little bit of backspin off of it. And then I'm going to aim it over on the right hand side. And then we're going to go 4.1 rings. Let's see how the shot turns out. Money. Money, money, money. Sweet. Okay. So we figured out that taking that backspin off and playing 20% and then pushing up is the right way to play. So that is a great start to hole two. All right, so hole number three, we're going to play with the quarterback and the horizon. And it's going to be with a par one ball. And we're just trying to get the ball down the fairway there. Set ourselves up for a horizon shot into the green. There's this little nook of rough that sticks out that we're gonna try to miss. We didn't do a good job of missing it last time. I'm gonna come to the left just a little bit. And then 3-6 is going to be 3.5 rings. Rocks are, or quarterbacks are almost always 1-1. So we'll do that and then push up to max. And then we're going to use just a little more than a half ball of curl. Hopefully that'll still be in range for a horizon shot as opposed to a backbone. Right, so it looks like we do have the horizon. It's gonna be kind of tough though. You can kind of see there's this funnel right here. Right like that. So 4-4. It's going to be 1-4 at mid. At min. So I'm just going to tuck this up a little bit like that. And then we'll go 1-4. It does look like we're going to need to underpower our shot just a little bit. And let's see how that works out. Just a little hot. So we want to make sure that we don't push up when we play our drive next time because those extra yards cost us from being able to really adjust properly for this shot. All right, so hole four is another par three, and we're gonna play with the backbone and a marlin ball. The shot was kind of tricky in the qualifier. We're definitely in between clubs, but I think that we have a spot where we can dial it in. All right, so 3-4 at max is going to be 2-3. We're going to come over here, put the yellow ring. Then I'm just going to use just about a little bit of topspin. And we said 2.3 rings. And see how that turns out. We did hit great last time, so that's probably why it went a little more left. So we might need to put one ball of less spin on it going forward. All right, so hole five, we are going to play with the extra mile and a horizon. And I'm gonna switch, make the switch to a power three ball from the way that we played the qualifier. I didn't like having to go into overpower with the extra mile. So I decided to go against it. So this way we won't have to go into overpower. At least not too much. Looks like we still are going to be behind the trees, so we might have to scale back that shot going forward. Okay, so I'm playing this at -5%, and so 3.5 is going to be 1.4 at max. I'm just going to play about 2 bars of topspin, and then we're going to put a little, excuse me, a little bit of curl on this. Hit great left, but it's not going to affect us too much. We're just going to end up missing the hole, but we're about pin high, so we'll be able to knock that in for eagle. All right, hole six. I've got an idea. I don't know if it's going to work or not, but we'll see. So power one ball, 10%. We might go to a power two or three ball depending on kind of what we see. But I definitely think that this is an eagle hole. So it does look like we can get there. So we're basically going to try this shot with a couple of rings of overpower. Let's see if we can clear the bunker. And we do. So that's definitely a eagle opportunity right there. Right, so hole seven, we're gonna play with the backbone and a par one ball. I think I put the wrong power one ball in. Let's just change it real quick. Nope, I have a navigator. Okay. So 15%. We were really, really close last time, so I just want to see if we can dial in this shot. Looked to me like it was just a matter of kind of the placement of our lineup. So 2.4 is going to be 1.7 at max. So we're going to go full back and 1.5 left. And then 2.4 is 1.7. Turn, turn, get there. Oh. We're getting closer. We are getting closer. All right, hole number 8. And for this one, we're going to use the quarterback with a guitar ball, power one. I really liked the setup with the quarterback last time. We were able to just kind of let it float out there. You know, with the good accuracy on the quarterback, it made it a little less drama-free than it would have been with the extra mile. So 4.5 is 4.3 rings. So we're gonna go full right, actually four right, and two top. And then we're just basically going to aim right there and put just a little bit of curl on it. And that gets us right up to the top here for a 5% backbone shot into the green. Alright, so backbone 5%. It's going to be 2.2 to 1.6. So you can kind of see that's max, that's min, so we're kind of right at mid, which is 1.9. So I'm just basically going to aim this at the hole. Adjust 1.9 rings. And hit great rate. It's like it's possible that perfect would have gone in. It's kind of hard to tell right there, but that's all right. We'll take a birdie here. All right, for hole 9, we are going to play with the extra mile, and I'm going to make a change over to the Viper from the Horizon that we were using. A little better accuracy, a little better backspin. So we just want to try to get on the green if we can get this shot over the fairway. Yeah, so let's go ahead and take the shot. So we barely made it over in the qualifier. I'm a little concerned with the depending on the wind that we get. Yeah, we had a 3.5 wind the first time around. So it's going to be tight. Boy, that's a tough shot from there. Brutal tough. Alright, so full top. We'll go 4 left. We only have a 3 wind. So we're basically going to go 10 rings from here. It's going to be like that. Oh, it just barely squeaks through. So tight. So we do know that 3.5 will get there. And we also have found out that 3 will get there as well. Alright, so I'm going to play this at negative 10%. You can kind of see with the Viper, we are at max right there. I'm just going to kind of tweak it a little bit. 4-3 is going to be 1.7 or 1.9. Looks like we do have that. So I'm basically going to go back as far as we can go. Should be to there. Let's see what happens with the shot. So safely on, that should be an eagle from there. Alright, so good opening round of 14 under. So that's going to be, I can almost tell you that we're already going to qualify. There are some people that are killing it out there, but we also have a chance to be killing it. So let's see what we can do on hole number 10. So we're going to be the Pisar and quarterback. Alright, so 4.2 is the wind, which is 4.1. Full top, full right. And we're going to pull this back up. And then that'll be a min, close to min distance thorn. So easy to hit the rough on that shot. Alright, so 2.7 at min is 0.7. And we're kind of at mid right now. So we'll go about one ring. So just a little under one bar of topspin, or backspin. And you can kind of see that there's that funnel right there. Problem is, we can't really find it too well. And let's see how this turns out. Again, we're just ever so slightly off. I'll have to look at the tape on hole one and see how we can correct it. I'm almost tempted to dunk it. Alright, hole two, or hole 11, we're going to play with the backbone and with a Marlin ball. So we dropped this on the opening round. I think we have it dialed in, but you never know. I don't remember exactly how many spin I used specifically. All right, so 4.6 at max is 3.3. I think that's what I did. Let's see how that turns out. Pretty close, just a little off. So I think I might need to offset a little bit, which is fine. We can work through that. You know, we're basically using this round as kind of a learn, dial in shot round. And it's gone very well so far, so we'll hope to keep doing it. I'm going to take you guys off the shootout. Alright, hole number 12 is up. Hole 3. And we're going to play with a quarterback horizon with a, I'm going to try a navigator ball just to cut down the wind a little bit. So if you remember from our tee shot, we were a little bit off, and so we're going to go ahead and cut down on pushing up after we adjust so that we do have a horizon shot, you know, without having to under adjust like we did the first time around. So the only difference is that we have less side spin, so we're going to have to put a little bit more curl on it, but that shouldn't be a big deal. So 3.5 is going to be 3.3. guess I will just put a little more curl on it. Great right isn't good, but we should still be okay. And so I'm hoping that'll be about, I don't know, 299, 300. So that should set us up better for this, for the second shot with the horizon. Alright, so second shot. Now we do have a good horizon shot here. So we're basically going to play with one bar of left spin and one bar of backspin. Maybe 2 bars of backspin. There we go. There's the funnel right there. So you can kind of see how it hangs right there. So 2-4, maybe about 0.9. And let's see if we can catch that. Still a little off. We must have over-adjusted a little bit. We'll dial it in for the weekend. At least we have a starting point now for how we want to line up the shot based on that tee shot with the other club. Alright, so we are now at 18 under through 12. And on to this little par 4. This one, like we said, is just one that we're trying to get a birdie and get out of there. One of those holes that I don't have any interest to figure out. I think that you can do a lot of damage in a rookie level without a true ball guide. Without, on this type of shot. So, if we can just safely get to within a couple yards and make the putt, then that's good enough for me. Wouldn't mind though trying to see if we could dial this in somehow. I just think you have to use like that. Yeah, I just don't know how much backspin that would be. Maybe just one bar backspin? I mean, 2 didn't look right. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Alright, so we're going to play hole 14. And I'm going to play with a power 3 ball. I might try this quarterback shot. See what it looks like. Just because I can put a little more curl on it to stay on the left-hand side. Going this way, I could definitely put some curl on it. Let's see how this looks. Nope, same problem. So I just need to use a little more curl, and then we can dial that in. Alright, so negative 10%, 3.7 is going to be 1.4 at max. So it looks like we might be able to dial this in. Let's see how this flies. A little short. But at least it got down that hill. So that we should have a pretty decent putt. Alright, so hole number 14. And we're going to try this shot again with the extra mile and disar ball. Worked out really good last time, so I'm hoping that we can keep it dialed in. Alright, so 5.1 is going to be 2.2 at max. So full top, or full back, and full right. And then we need to get up to 2 rings of overpower. Let's see how that flies. Gets onto the fairway, so we get a shot. All right, so we are minus 23. Let me just close out a couple of these apps. And hole 16 is par 3. So we're going to try this with the backbone. And a par 1 ball. We We've been really close, so let's see if we can just get it dialed in. All right, so 15% is going to be 2.3. I'll try to play a little differently, see if we can get it dialed. Felt really good. Turn. It still doesn't turn. Oh man. Just will not turn. It's almost like we need to get set up on the left side. Alright, onto hole 17. And we're going to play with the quarterback and backbone. With a power one ball. So this will be a 10% elevation change. And we're gonna go, two seemed a little scary to me on the top spin, so I think I'll try it again, but make sure that I don't use any overpower and just kind of see if that works out. Alright, so 4.7, 4.6, I'm not actually concerned about that. We're going to go full 4 right and 2 top. And then we're just going to use just a little bit of curl. So even without using any overpower, it still is really, really close. Alright, so 5% at 4.9 is going to be 2.8 at mid. So I'm going to use about a ball of right curl and 2 backspin. And then we're going to adjust 2.8. See, it does come in hot, so I'll have to look at the landing position and see if we can add maybe like another half a ball of curl. We were dead on right there. Alright, last hole. So we're going to play with the extra mile and a Titan ball. And I need to make sure that we have the extra mile with the Viper in there. I really like the way that that looked last time. It's a risky tee shot. I think that, I don't know, I have some ideas if we find a win today that isn't going to work. Yeah, 2.5, wow. I just think this isn't going to work. I want to go 3 left. You know what? Let's try the big topper. Let's find out if this is going to work or not. Did not work. Okay. Well, now we know. We need to go more rings at the big topper. That 2.5 mile wind scared me. But in the end, I think that we're just going to have to do it every time. If it works out, it works out. If it doesn't work out, then such is life. Because now we have a hard shot just to get onto the fairway. So it does look like we can get up there. I don't think we're going to be able to get in a thorn range, but you never know. No, we're definitely not in thorn range. Alright, so hopefully it's still going to be a backbone shot. Looks like it is. Okay. So we're just basically going to curl this. So 4.2... minus 20. We'll go about 2 rings. And then we should be able to make our birdie putt from there. Alright, so all in all, a good round. We shot 14 under on the front and 12 under on the back. I think we can definitely work with that extra mile shot on 9 and 18. I think in the weekend round, I might just go with a berserker to make sure we get over, but I'll have to take a look at that. We did get the drop on 2 in the opening, drop on 2 in the front 9. And we figured out that 6 is a repeatable shot to get on the green or get close and make that chip. So, good day at the office. Thanks, guys, for watching. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you like what you see. And we will catch up next time. Thank you.